Hey guys, welcome back to Little Nightmares. I'm Zach and I'm in the driver's seat.
I'm Juliana and I'm in the back seat.
And we're doing it wrong. We thought the last episode was going to be the end, but then there was more to it than we thought.
And there was lots of dying.
Which you already know, so...
We just decided to cut it.
And go from there. Okay.
You made it!
Nailed it!
Oh my god.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Sweet feathery bunions. See, and this is why,
dick.
Snorkel face. What the hell, man? He's not gonna give up.
But he's nice and
fleshy,
bouncy. He can't turn around. He's not quickly. Oh Jesus! Oh Jesus! Oh Jesus! Oh Jesus!
He's hungry. He's hungry. Yeah. He's hungry.
Don't know how. I don't know. But oh, you fat mother piece of shit!
And this is how we start our episodes.
Okay.
You ready?
Yep. I know what to do.
You ready, Freddy?
Yep. Attention.
Run, run, wait. Run, run, wait. Sprint and make it through it the first time, actually.
Bitches ain't trick shit, but hoes and tricks. Ooh, snap.
Doll.
Doll. Oh, God. Kitchen gnome. Fuck. Shit, how the fuck am I supposed to get there?
Yeah, I think you're just, like, I think that's a completionist run, which we won't be doing on camera.
No. I don't got time for that shit.
Alright, run, 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 run. Keep running.
Okay, yep.
Hide. Hide in the thing. Or there. That works too.
Okay. Alrighty.
So I think you toss those in the open toilet and use that. Or you climb up the sink, maybe? I don't know. Yeah, toss those in the open toilet. Then you can climb on them. Nope.
Wait a minute.
Just don't kill yourself in the glass.
Squeeze on through.
To the other side. Break on through to the other side. Yes, you guys get to be serenaded by me.
Well, that's how I get the fucking doll.
If you want to repeat.
Well, I need to get down.
Break the dolly. Oh, and then you gotta use the elevator.
Yep.
Elevator.
Super observant. Up. Didn't even notice the elevator go. Okay.
Wait. No squeal. Okay. Maybe he thinks it was a guest. Apparently it was a guest that he thought used to. Like, know me. I like you, but that's some fucked up shit, man.
Ass. No, put his hand in a bucket of water.
I think you're actually supposed to bounce on that guy and get up.
Oh, light. Sorry. I'm just like, save! For the love of all that is holy, save!
Oh, the gnome saved me. So what do we have in here? Jesus.
Food, weren't you?
Place down.
Oh god. Oh god. Go. Go. You can do it, I believe.
Ah! Oh god.
You can do it, jump.
Oh shit. That's Mr. Dangley's hat.
I know.
But he don't got no hands. Oh shit. This again.
Yeah, I knew it was coming soon.
It had to. Dying of hunger. Becoming the very thing I fear. Nomi, you back off that sausage! Oh, you
always giving it to me. No!
Becoming the very thing I fear. Because you tasted the rat, and suddenly, not raw meat wasn't good enough anymore. That was brutal. Okay. Need to be closer.
General rule with projectiles, closer is usually better. Explosives, definitely not the same.
Oh, yes.
But projectiles.
Specifically projectiles. Bullets, arrows, cans. Okay. Completed the guest area. Right. Oh shit. Okay. Well.
Yep, you have to go up the stairs. I'm also kind of getting like a Spirited Away feel from this.
Yes, definitely. I need to find a key.
There is an open door.
There is an open door.
And, if you would hold on 1 minute, because I'm getting light right in my face. Boop, boop, boop.
Okay, this is going to be terrifying. Yep. Okay.
At least it was kind of quick.
Kind of. There's likely an up that I need to go. Yep.
Dresser?
That's my guess. Yep.
But where from here? Can you open it? Oh, you can't open the dresser.
No, I can't. Jesus!
And there's nowhere else you can go around here.
Mm-mm. Not that I found.
But, well, there's some close to us.
Yeah.
Can you climb on the dolls?
No, I don't think so.
Is the key there? On the top of it? No. No. That's square. Alright. Do you jump to the light? No, you can't jump to the light. No, man. Don't know. Have you tried on the far side? Like, trying to come in close to her instead of the far? Like, because there's some chairs and stuff that you might, well, you can't hide under, but you might be able to climb on top of.
I think if I just go super slow. Yep. God. She's got a doll on her dresser.
Mm-hmm. I saw that when we first got in, but I was like, that'll be a problem for later.
Now, where's this fucking key?
In the drawer. Like, it's in that drawer.
Very likely that it's in the drawer. It's probably in the jar. Called it. Slow.
dolly?
Nope.
I think supposedly it helps, like, get rid of some of her power.
It's possible.
But no, not right now.
Not gonna worry about it.
Like, all those things, like, creep me out because I'm like, oh shit, it's her! And then I see
right? Like, she could be any fucking one of those.
Like, the only thing that tells me it's not is the hair.
Yeah. I mean, the lack thereof.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that was absolutely horrifying.
By the way, I think that's this one's mom. Just throwing that out there.
There she is. Yep. Jesus.
There she is again.
Yep. Oh, God. Okay, well, I need to be running through there.
Although, I think you're not wrong about it this being, like...
The end.
The end.
Yeah. Yep.
Slide!
Whoa! Now what?
She appears again.
I'm getting... Apparently, you can only run for so long. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, she's gonna show up again. Somewhere. Oh boy, final boss.
Up to the eyeball.
Oh, yeah.
There's a way up there, I think. Okay, let's try the other side.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, jeez.
Lots of broken mirrors.
Go up. I don't know. Are you supposed to use that against her?
Yes. Because you notice how all the mirrors she's...
using are broken.
Uh-huh. Because she uses her gaze. Come at me, bitch. Come on. What you got? Where are you at?
It's...
stay out of the light. Ah, damn it. Well,
she is the light, so you have to reflect light onto her.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Yay, Medusa!
Yay, right?
Sorry, excuse me. What's his face? Perseus. Perseus taught us all a valuable lesson at one point. Maybe.
Okay, let's do this.
You can do it. I believe. So, find the light.
So she do her thing.
And then go into it and shine it. Shine bright.
There we go. Yeah. Okay. We're on the right track. So get into the light, which baits her out.
Yep.
And then...
figure out where she's coming from.
There's two.
Probably 5 to 10.
I was gonna say 3 to 5.
With this type of attack, it's...
10 is gonna be way too much.
Right, but 5 to 10 is about normal for this type of non-combat situation.
That did it.
Seven.
It's always an odd number. Okay. The mirror's broken.
Yeah, but... Well, it's extra glowy bits.
Oh, fuck. And her neck is exposed. Oh. Nope. Oh, just desserts, I suppose?
Potentially. I want to see the pictures that have the face covered up.
How do you mean? That have
the shrouds over them, because they were very specific. And a couple of them that I saw were some girl wearing yellow.
Oh, those pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That was brutal.
Oh, I think that's since you only got four, but if you had all the other gnomes.
Probably.
Just thought, for those of you playing for your own fun.
Well, that was an experience. That was good.
Yeah.
That was a really good game. I honestly wish it was longer. I had heard complaints that it was short, and I can see why people would complain about that, but...
There's a lot that happens, so I'm...
There's
an intensity factor I think they took into account, and I know there's DLC out, but...
There is DLC, and we'll probably play that. We'll probably give it a little bit of time, but we will do the DLC, and we'll probably do it just all in one go, just get it done. Because it's my understanding that it's really short, too. So, we'll do that. But I really like this game. The only complaint I had about it was the controls. The controls were infuriating. They were so... Just, they were clumsy. They were very clumsy controls. But the storytelling, even though there was no narration, there was no dialogue, I feel like the storytelling in this game was fantastic.
Yeah, and the presence of all of the characters, like he said last episode, even watching here, like I could get a sense of, you can tell when they're around, like you're always on edge with this game, mm-hmm. but like there's just this atmosphere when you're playing that
because
something's gonna be happening.
Even when you're not in, like, if there's no one around, there's no background music, or it's very subtle background music, but you could always tell if and when one of the enemies was going to be around, because you could hear the just very subtle, very
like
subtle music, or like just a very subtle soundtrack and theme song for each of the different characters. Like with the chefs in the kitchen, not last episode, but the episode before, there was one where you could just hear when we had to sneak around the dual beds and the double butthole folks. When we had to sneak around the tool beds, yes, I'm going to sneak in double bundle as much as I can.
I know.
When you had to sneak around those two beds, you could just hear, you were not in imminent danger as long as you were quiet, but you could just hear this very subtle kind of lumber. And I need to go back and look and see if there's anything like that for Mr. Dangley. But just the way this game presented itself and the way this game... the length and the controls are the only complaints I have about this game. Beyond that, it was fantastically executed. It was fantastically... It was just a good game.
Yeah,
it was a great
game. I agree with their length and then doing DLC, because I could see for what somebody might think would be okay for a younger audience would immediately go, no, this is all you're playing. I would not suggest this for a younger audience.
This is not a game for the younger folk. There is some heavy shit in here.
Yeah. And
like, the subtle steps of brutality as the character gets more and more hungry as you go. It's just like, someone helps, so there's raw meat, and then there's another chunk of raw meat, which gets her captured. And then the next time she's hungry, she eats a fucking rat alive. And then the last one was kind of to be expected.
Yeah, that was.
But the one before that, where, you know, you walk in and you're like, oh, it's little Nomi! And, I mean, you saw my reaction to that. That was fucking...
That we were not ready for.
We were not ready for that. How she just grabs the fucking gnome
and just...
instead of the sausage. It's like, fuck!
Yeah. So, I mean...
And the graphics were good in that game. The depth of field was really good in that game. Like, I've seen other games that have tried to portray depth of field, but it was in no way. And I even mentioned that in our... in one of the episodes of Dragon Age that we did. I think it's the second episode. That the way they did depth of field was just so clunky. And that's an older game, so you gotta kind of hand it to them. It was really good at the time. But in some of the newer games today, it's hard to do depth of field properly.
Right, and then there's also, like, what they did to showcase that were these little, small, just pristine details that I haven't seen a lot of game makers do recently. Like it didn't necessarily always fit the style of where you were at, mm-hmm. but there'd just be these very precise and just absolutely stunning details, like the bubbles in yeah. the dish room.
Right.
But there's also like nuts and bolts and the way they shine, or glass on the floor.
Mm-hmm.
And although it didn't cut our feet, you know, that
although
glass
it didn't cut
is
our feet,
very hard.
Although it didn't cut our feet, it made noise if you stepped on it.
Well, and it would shimmer and shine in some mm-hmm. lights, and that's hard.
The lighting in this game. I haven't seen lighting in a game this good in a really long time.
So, as much as we have to say that this is dark and heavy material...
Well, it's not untrue that I haven't seen lighting like this. I have seen lighting like this, but it's always been in, like, AAA titles. Fucking Crysis, the new Battlefield games, the new... Like, all of those new big blockbuster games, they always, you know, they always usually have really good graphics, really good lighting. But in a smaller, more indie game like this, to have lighting like that, holy shit.
Yeah, so a lot of what you'll hear from us is praise all the time about what we see and like and do.
And the soundtrack.
Yes.
In general. Like, just the little subtle... The very subtle things, like right now. That's impressive to me.
Yeah. So, and that's something that we like to play games that we like.
Yes.
Whether the controls are clunky or not, it's something we do. We mm-hmm. have chosen to kind of, we might try something out and then go, nope, I don't like it, it's not right.
Like Murder Soul Suspect.
Yeah, that
like,
was...
The concept of that game is great, but the storytelling is just so slow. It was so slow.
Yeah, we had gotten to the point we were out of exposition, and it still hadn't...
We still didn't really know what the fuck was going on.
Yeah.
And it was hard to tell what was going on. We might revisit that sometime later down the line, but for now, we're pretty much just done with that game. And
right.
we're done with this one.
Well, but that's because we finished this one.
We did finish this one.
Also... I'm not sure where this comes in the schedule, if it's before or after Lumino City, but, yeah, that's
I'm
another
sure
one,
this is
so
gonna be, yeah.
that's,
yeah,
we're
this
done
is
with that
be...
one, and, I'm happy that we're done with it in that, you know, it opens the way for something new, but
yes.
I'm sad to see that one go as well,
mm-hmm.
but, like I said, we like to praise the games we play, and... Like, this one kept me on the edge of my seat as an observer.
And as a player, like, there were times where I felt genuine panic in some of those moments, where it was just like, oh god, what do I do? Because it's just like, you reach the point where, what do you do?
Yeah. So, yeah.
Oh.
Oh.
There is a thing afterward.
Good thing we stayed.
Good thing we stayed. Okay.
Oh.
Thank you for playing.
Thank you for making this.
Thank you for making this.
Did they sink it? Did she sink it?
Well, it looks like that's just how it is.
That would explain a lot. Oh, you can move? Can you move?
No, I can't.
Okay. It's just the next back. Okay.
Yep. But yeah, that was an incredible game. That was... I'm blown away. That was...
Yeah.
Top shit right there.
Well, and that's what I'm going... The length of the game is...
It was...
Is considerate to the amount of panic and anxiety they're putting you through, because... There are very few moments where we were just like, okay, we can really catch our breaths here. We are safe for the moment.
Yeah, there were very few just points where we felt like we could stop. But I think we've said all we can really say about this.
And thank you to the makers of this game. And thank you guys for watching.
As always.
If you will please like, comment, subscribe, and let us know if we're doing it wrong in the comments down below.
Catch you guys in the next series.
Bye.
You're little.